Hello, BSc first year students, listen here. In today's lecture, we'll start the chapter number 2. So, yesterday we have completed the chapter number 1. That chapter is very short. That is the introduction to the developmental biology. So, developmental biology is nothing but the embryology. Another name to the developmental biology is the embryology. And embryology starts from the fertilization up to the hatching or birth of an animal. Today, we will start the next chapter after the introduction to developmental biology. The second chapter is the early embryonic period. Early embryonic period, it is before the zygote formation. Early embryonic period. So, dear students, in this early embryonic period, there is the gametogenesis in your syllabus. Ya chapter madhe early embryonic period madhe aplyala syllabus madhe je point dilele ahe te point apan abhyasnar ahot. So in early embryonic period, this chapter, the first point is gametogenesis, and we will study gametogenesis. So here, before the gametogenesis, we should know some summary or terminology which is very helpful to understand the developmental biology or embryology. Dear students, so the offspring or new one which is just come out from the egg or which is just come out from the mother's body after the birth. So that is the offspring, new one, pillu jalapama. So that is immature. That is immature, not sexually mature. So after some days, after a particular period, there is the maturity. And in some of the animals, after the maturity, we can identify the male and female. You are understanding me? For example, in the hens, the new ones which is coming out from the egg, andyamadun, andyacha tarpala madun je bahar alela pillu aahe, that young ones, nobody can identify whether it is a male or whether it is the female. But after some days, the maturity, there is a sexual characters. That characters, with the help of that characters, externally, you can observe and you can say which one is the female and which one is the male. Kombidicha pillu mottha jhalyanantar, mature jhalyanantar, sexual maturity jhalyanantar, tyachyamadhye sexual dimorphism or sexual dimorphic characters are developed. Tyachya head is varti, on the head there is the comb. So if that comb is larger, then we can say it is the cock, means it is the male. And if that comb is very small, so we can say it is the female, it is the hen, cock and hen. C-O-C-K, cock manje kombda, you know that, kombda is the male and hen is the female. So, they are showing the sexual dimorphism. The characters which we can see externally and we can identify the male and female. So it means sexual dimorphism is present in that animals. In some of the animals, externally, just after the born or just after the birth, we can identify whether this is the male and this is the female. Mulga hai ki mulgi hai, janmalya barabar apan sangu shakto. On the basis of the external characters. So sexual dimorphism is present. In some of the animals, sexual dimorphism is absent. For example, in the case of fish, if you are having a large number of fish, can you identify which is the male and which is the female? Freshwater fish from our local market of Jintur. Jintur cha bazara madhe cha fish vikayla alele, Yeldari dam cha fish vikayla alele, topla bhar fish alele. Tumhi externally tya fish la olkhu shakta? Konta nar aahe, konta madi aahe? You cannot identify the fishes, which is the fresh water. In the marine water, you can identify. Because marine water fishes, some of the marine water fishes, they are having the sexual dimorphism. In the male, claspers are present. And in the female, claspers are absent. So here, early embryonic period, so sexes are separate. Sexes are separate. Maybe the sexual dimorphism present or maybe the absent, but sexes are separate. Male and female, these two animals are different. And male animal or female animal, they are having the gonads. They are having the gonads. So dear students, when we are studying the developmental biology or embryology, so there is a character and that character is the sex. What is a sex? So remember, sex is a character and each character having the two alternatives. Remember, sex is a character and that character having the two alternatives, male and female. You are understanding me? In general, male and female. So height is a character and that height character having the two alternatives, that is the tall and dwarf, Munchani Gutka. In general, two characters are there. One character having the two alternatives. So here, sex. Sex means it is a character of animal and there are two alternatives, male and female. So when we are discussing about the sex, so the students of other faculties, they will laugh to us. Apnele haastin. Sex matlabar haastin. So sex, what is the sex? Sex is a character of animals. It may be male and female. So remember, sex is a character. Maybe male or maybe female. Sex ha mogam shabda hai. Sex matlanta to male asu shakto to female asu shakto. So similarly, in the male or in the female, there is the gonad. Gonad suddha has mogam shabda hai, jasa sex hai, and sex che don alternative hai, male female. Thus a gonad. Gonad is also having the two alternatives. That is the male gonad, which is present in the male animal body, and female gonad, which is present in the female animal body. So here, the male gonad is also called as the testes. And testes produces the male gamete, which is called as the sperm. So gamete, here gamete, gamete has shabda suddha mogam hai. Gamete mhatlyanantar which gamete, male gamete or female gamete? If male gamete, then it is called as the sperm. And if it is the female gamete, then it is called as the ova. So here, the common word, sex, the common word, gonad, the common word, gamete. So sex, two types, male, female. Gonad, two types, testes and ovaries. Then, gametes, two types, male gamete, which is called as the sperm, and female gamete, which is called as the ovum. So in the taste is, there is the production or formation of the sperms, development of the sperms. Similarly, on the other hand, in the female animal body, there is the female gonad that is called as the ovary, and ovary produces the female gamete, which is called as the ova. So, gametogenesis means the process of formation of the gametes. The process of formation of gametes is in the male animal body. So, it means the formation of the sperms, and then that is called as the spermatogenesis. Similarly, in the gamete formation in the female animal, then that is called as the oogenesis, ova formation, oogenesis. So, here in the gametogenesis, we have to study the gamete formation. So, it is the process of development of gametes. What is the gametogenesis? So, remember simply and in short but sweet definition is the process of development of gametes is called as the gametogenesis. So, male animal having the male gonad, that is called as the testes. Testes produces the male gamete, that is called as the sperm. And you know the structure of a sperm. Female gonad present in the female animal body, it is called as the ovary, it produces the female gamete, and female gamete is called as the ova, and that process is called as the oogenesis, that process is called as the spermatogenesis, that we will study in next period. So here there are different stages in gametogenesis, there are different stages. How many stages are there? You don't know. You are learning today. So remember, in the gametogenesis, there is the three stages. Gametogenesis process includes the three stages. And they are, kontya te aahet ya? Kontya teen stages aahet? Tar ek aahe, first aahe, multiplication phase. Second aahe, growth phase. And third aahe, maturation phase. So, phase means a stage. So, here we will study the first, that is the multiplication phase. So, in the gonads, there is the germ cells. Remember, in our body, two types of cells are present in our body. In the animal body, there are two types of the cells. Somatic cells and germinal cells. So, germinal cells are present in the gonads. Maybe in the male gonad, maybe in the female gonad. And somatic cells are present in the other body organs, except the gonads. So the germ cells which is present in the gonads that undergo. Here you listen, see here, germ cells of the gonads means germ cells of the testes or germ cells of the ovaries undergo in repeated division again and again, further and further. So to form many cells. So that is called as the multiplication phase. Multiply, huna. Number of cells are increasing. So, that is called as the multiplication phase. So, the germ cells undergoes in the repeated division to form the many cells. And all divisions are the mitotically or mitotic. You know mitosis and meiosis. One cell divided into two cells, that is called as the mitotic division or mitosis. Now, another stage is the growth phase. What happened in the growth phase? There is the growth or increase in size of the cell. Just cells is a multiplication phase madhe mitotic division hoon, just cells tayar zala, tya cells growth hone, kiwa tya cells size vaadne, increase the size, that is called as the growth phase. Vaad hone. Then next phase is the maturation phase. So maturation phase means there is the maturation of the cells. And here it includes the two divisions. One is the first maturation division and second maturation division. A and B. This numbering is also having the one discipline. First stage, second stage, third stage. In third stage, there are again two divisions, A and B. So, in first maturation division, It is also called as the meiotic division. Mitotic and meiotic. Here, the chromosome numbers are reduced to half. If the chromosomes are 24, then in this stage, the chromosome number becomes the half, means 12. So here chromosomes are reduced. So this is also called as the reduction phase. And second maturation division, so this is similar to the mitotic division. Here gametes have haploid number of chromosomes. So dear students, in today's period, we have started the second chapter. Name of the chapter is the early embryonic period. And in this chapter, we have studied the first bit, that is the gametogenesis. Gametogenesis having the three stages, that is the multiplication phase, growth phase, maturation phase. Maturation phase, again having the two divisions, first maturation division, second maturation division. So for today, it is sufficient. In next period, we will see the next process in this chapter. So this is the early embryonic period before the fertilization. So dear students, send your presentee as early as possible. लवकरात लवकर तुमची प्रेझेंटी तुम्ही पाठवून द्यायची. उद्या परवा पाठवू असं जमत नाही, कारण उद्या माझा दुसरा पीरियड होईल. सो तुमचे चान्स जे अटेंडन्स पाठवायचे, दॅट विल फिनिश टुमारो. सो यू सेंड युअर प्रेझेंटी ॲज अर्ली ॲज पॉसिबल. हे पीरियड ऑनलाईन लेक्चर तुमच्या व्हॉट्सअपवरती आल्यानंतर तुम्ही पहिल्यांदा काय काम करायचं, तर तुम्ही त्याला ऑब्झर्व करायचं आणि तुमची प्रेझेंटी पाठवायची. प्रेझेंट इज सिंपल पाठवायची. प्रेझेंट सर आणि तुमचं नाव, तुमचं स्वतःचं आडनाव आधी आणि नंतर तुमचं नाव. रिमेंबर, कधी आपलं आडनाव आधी लिहायचं. कम्प्युटर मध्ये जी लिस्ट तयार होते आडनावानं तयार होते. आडनाव काय, तसंच आपण एक फॉर्मॅट वापरायचं की आपण कधी आपलं आडनाव आधी आणि नंतर आपलं नाव. ओके.